Good day, YouTube. We're gonna make a game engine from scratch. Well, how? Why? What's the need of it? We already have so many game engines like Unity, Unreal, Godot. What's the need of you making a new game engine that probably nobody's gonna make a game on? Well, your question is really right. It doesn't provide any practical value. There are so many game engines out there. If you wanna make a game, you can use any of them and your game is gonna work on so many platforms, and you're gonna have to code it only once, and it just works for you. It works like magic. You don't have to look at all the details and intricacies that go in the backside of it. You're just making a game and it works for you. Your project files are saved. You can do any kind of game in all of these game engines. I have nothing against them. I have used Unity since the past 6 years, and after some 4 or 5 years I started getting bored with how I'm just opening the same application and doing the same things that I do. I wanted something more to improve my own self, so I started learning OpenGL and all of those graphics APIs. And then I thought of to myself that why should I not make a game engine from scratch? And I did. It was bare bones basic game engine. I made this last year, but from now what we're gonna do is make a game engine from scratch. And when I say scratch, I'm saying literally no libraries, but just the Windows ones. And what do I mean by the window libraries? Just this one, you see. To display a window, you need something, you know, all of these borders and these options. This is using Win32 API, if I'm not wrong. And that's about it. We're not gonna use any other library. We're not gonna use OpenGL, nothing. All the graphics pipeline we're gonna implement ourselves. Now, what's the need of this? It already has been done. Well, imagine you go to a dealership. You want a bike. You look at this one bike, it's really good. It's shining, it has chrome job all over it. You rev it, it revs it smooth, it sounds really nice. You take it out for the test ride. You do 60s and 90s on it, it works. Nothing's wrong with it. You feel amazing, you buy it. And now you own it, it's yours. Right? It's fun riding that motorcycle. You can do... The engine is really forgiving, right? But if you're into mechanics and you want a little bit more of how things work and how this is done, even though if you don't have a mechanical background, you can just Google. You can find this detail from internet, this part from somewhere else, and then put a little crappy engine together. It might not do even 20s and it might explode, but still. After making your own engine, even though it's crappy, you cannot beat the satisfaction of riding that engine. Even if you ride a world-class motorcycle. You see where I'm getting with this? This project is only for the people who wanna know how game engines work and what happens on the inside. And to keep things really basic, I have decided to not use any kind of graphics pipeline either. No graphics things we're using. We're not using OpenGL, not Vulkan, not DirectX, even though I know these things. Let's talk about the scale of this project. Because this project sounds really big, we have to shorten it to make it feasible for us, because it's just me. The first thing comes into mind, like, what platforms are we gonna use? So we're just gonna have Linux and Windows. And for these two platforms, the only libraries we're gonna ever use are just X11 for showing Windows on Linux, like these kind of Windows, and Win32 API for showing the Windows on our Windows. I'm not sure if it works in Windows 11, but Windows 10 it works. They still should have Win32 API in Windows 11, I don't know. So, what else? Well, we want our game engine to look like this. look like any other game engine. This is like our file minus, it's here, and we have this minimize button, maximize button, and the close button. And then here we have like the contents, like the game explorer thing, and this is our scene hierarchy, and this is our scene view, and this is our game view. We can switch between them, basically how most of the game engine looks. And this is our inspector. Well, to do all of this, it needs such a big code base. Well, we're gonna do this step by step, and at the end of the day, we're gonna have a game engine, and we can build a game, we can save the scenes, and we can finally do the things that game engines are known for. Like making a game. It should be able to make a executable file if we're on Windows, and other like no extension executable file, or in Linux we can call our game anything, and this is gonna be a static library. Yeah, that is the scope of this project, and in the next video we're gonna start with setting our project up. So if you want to make a game engine from scratch and you don't want to use anything and you like the way I do things, you can follow me along and I'll try to make things simple for you. Thank you so much for watching, and hope you have a good day. Take care.